It was business as usual at Victoria Station this afternoon, as yet more school parties were either returning home or taking the boat train to a holiday abroad. For the teachers, a nightmare.
Well, it's constantly counting, really, that's the main thing. And making sure that all the children are with one, which isn't particularly easy at times, but that's really the crucial thing.
Can there ever be enough supervision?
Well, if you have willful children who go off and do things on their own, no. But then parents can't supervise their children all the time either.
3 years ago, a party from Stoke Poges in Buckinghamshire set off with confidence for a trip to Land's End. Four boys drowned, swept to their deaths by a wave as they walked near the foot of the cliffs. The inquiry which followed led to a 22-point guideline on safety that was circulated to schools nationwide. It said trips should be better planned, that danger areas should be checked out well in advance, and that teachers should make sure they supervise activities effectively, however difficult the conditions. All common sense precautions, according to former headmaster and education minister Sir Rhodes Boyson.
It is vital there's enough teachers for the number of pupils, and that should be laid down, the number of pupils per teacher, or teachers per pupil if you want it the other way. Secondly, they must have good equipment. It must be checked as to where they're going. If it's mountain walking, there must be mountain shoes or whatever is required for that. Fell walking on proper boots. And for all weathers, they must have the right equipment. And thirdly, there must be first-class discipline. They must know that if a person says you cannot do it, that must not be done. And nobody should take people on holiday who are not under their 100% control. And fourthly, whenever one is out, there should be a master at the front, a master at the back, and one in the middle.
These photographs were taken 33 years ago, when Rhodes Boyson was himself the leader of school trips abroad, then a rarity, now undertaken by an estimated 600,000 schoolchildren every year.
It shouldn't be actually a cheap family holiday. It should be something which was purposeful, where children enjoy it, and yet they learn. And if they do not learn, then they should not be organised. In that case, they do not fulfil an educational purpose.